Now, our regular viewers would have noticed that we've had a winter of cold, miserable weather. The wind's always coming from the east. Sometimes it's frozen. It always rains and it's plumbing freezing. But look at it now! Let's get fishing! As you can tell, I'm very excited. I'm probably a little bit too pumped, actually, with all the vitamin D that's coming into me. I'm also quite excited by all this N'ZON stuff that Daiwa have sent me. I've got a couple of new feeder rods to take a look at, and I've got an absolute gem of a reel I want to show you. Well, it's off to a very slow start, and although you can't see what's going on around the lake, there's Mr. Nudd over there being filmed. There's some other guys over there being filmed. And yeah, we had a massive frost last night, and the carp clearly don't want to play ball at the moment. But that's my first fish, little skimmer. But I have put a short line in with this rod. And I'll tell you why, and I'll tell you what the rod is as soon as I pop this in the net. So let me introduce you to the two Daiwa N'ZON rods that I brought with me today. They're both from the super slim range, but they're very, very different rods. This here is a two-piece method feeder rod. You might think that's a bit of a strange choice to fish a short line, which I'm doing here at Meadowlands, thinking about skimmers and maybe an odd carp. And this one here is a three-piece rod. And this is the medium feeder. Don't get carried away by the medium. It's quite a pokey thing. But if you want to get a method feeder out there, which I do, it's ideal for that, and I think it's got quite a few other uses, but we'll deal with those as we go on. Now, this, I was absolutely taken away by this last night when I kitted it up. This is the 20 N'ZON distance reel. It comes in under 100 pounds. Firstly, the spool. So I reckon I put around about 180 to 200 yards of 6-pound line on it, which went on there really, really easy. It's got, I think it's a 4.6 to 1 gear ratio, but it picks up 92 centimeters of line per handle crank. Now that's impressive stuff, but it's nowhere near as impressive. From the minute I picked this reel up, the power that it's got is quite unbelievable. So if you're looking for a reel, like I always say, if you do the Irish festivals where you're really heavy on reels, you know, there's a lot of casting with heavy feeders, it's tough on all tackle there, you know, chucking it about. And especially a reel, because you'll be constantly catching fish and winding in big feeders and biggest fish. It's one of the most powerful Daiwa reels that I've seen. It's sort of like, it's like a Land Rover Defender, you know. This isn't like a Bazzia, which is like you could might think would be like a Ferrari. This is a proper workhorse of a reel, but in a good way. Robust, strong, I absolutely adore it. And you would think Daiwa reels can cost an awful lot of money, but this thing, under 100 pound, two line clips, really nice sort of graphic-y sort of carbon front. It's not a QD, but it's, you know, you can set it up easy enough. And I'm absolutely taken with that. Now, I think we've got one on the braid rod and we've missed it. That's why it's called fishing and not catching. And you might think that, why is the old boy fishing with a method feeder rod on such a short line? Well, I'll tell you. I looked at the rods when Daiwa sent them in, and such is its forgiving action that I thought that would make a lovely sort of short line braid rod. And as my mate and work colleague Dan Webb told me, there are loads of sort of big skimmers on the short line. And although it carries a method feeder tag, it's not what you expect, this super slim rod. It's got a really progressive action, but it's very, very soft. And even I'm fishing with an 012 braid, it's absolutely perfect for that sort of short distance work. Even if you're targeting skimmers, it's got enough cushioning in it to easily sort of work for you without pulling a hook out. Now, when I came into Meadowlands this morning, I thought, yeah, we'll start short, catch a few skimmers, and hopefully as the day warms up, you know, we'll have a look for some carp with an altogether different rod. What I didn't think was that I'd ever set a new PB. I didn't see that Meadowlands had that sort of fish in it. Take a look at this. that is the biggest gudgeon I've ever caught. No doubt fed on a healthy diet of pellets. It's a gargantuan gudgeon. Goodbye, PB gudgeon. It's been a pleasure. All the years of fishing have been worth the effort. It looks like the vitamin D's found its way through to the carp as well. And yeah, Dan, who's doing another live test jump from, has just had a carp. So I thought we'll have a switch off that inside line and put the feeder out, and wallop, it's gone round. And now you can see what I was on about medium feeder. There's lots of power there. I mean, it wouldn't just be a good barbel rod, this. It wouldn't just be a good method rod. It'd also be an outstanding barbel rod because it's loading really high up on the blank on the cast. So if you used it on a big river, it wouldn't fold over on the heavy flow. You know, it would keep reasonably stiff. Nice fittings on this rod, nicely got, you know, I like the way they put the guides on there. Very impressive. And that's got a very powerful action. Look at that. Now, the three-piece design, why I've chose that is, and I remember it's a conversation I had years ago with Tommy Pickering, told me that, you know, when it came to sort of proper feeder rods, you couldn't really beat a three-piece design. And whilst sort of two-piece design suit commercial carp, because we like that progressive action, when you need that bit longer chuck, the three-piece design is an easier rod to design as a distance rod or with a little bit of power, because you can make it quite stiff, and then most of the action is up in that carrier section, which is exactly what this rod is doing. You know, it's of a perfect design. Now, I'm not saying you can't get good two-piece rods that can chuck a distance, because there's certainly some out there, but some of them can be very expensive. Anyway, I think this carp is just about done, but I think that's a proper fish. And I have to say, the rod itself, the action is everything I would hoped it would be. And as much as I'm throwing the feeder around with it, I don't know, casting distance would be, I don't know, probably, I don't see you couldn't get 100 yards out of it. And it's got a casting weight of 120, and I'm fishing with, what, 35, it's probably about 40 gram feeder, so not even half of what it's capable of doing. And it's certainly not weight wise for casting. I'm not even close to sort of bottoming it out or anything like that. There is a lot of power there. It's almost like an old school dial rod. You know, they used to make them, I remember the red and one had green sort of whippings and the other had red, and they were the like really original sort of Daiwa feeder rods. We used them a lot on the Trent many years ago, and they had that same sort of steely feel that this rod's got. But you have to say that Daiwa, you know, the N'ZON, their own N'ZON stuff, which I think like the legend for it was hit your target. So it really is sort of set up for feeder fishing. There's stuff to sort of suit every type of feeder fishing within the range. But that is a brute of a carp. And if he's not gonna jump around too much, we'll pop him straight back in. But welcome to spring, mate. Now, amongst a load of stuff that Daiwa sent me was a stink bag. Seen a stink bag before, but never with one of these in it. This is an unhooking mat. And I thought, I'm not sure I'm never going to need an unhooking mat unless I'm actually going for sort of, maybe if I go down the river for big barbel or something. But then when you see a fish like that, you think, yeah, you can't pick that up. You know, you can't stand up with it because it's not fish friendly. It certainly isn't fishery friendly. So yeah, great idea from Daiwa that. We really like that. And look at that. That's the reason to have an unhooking mat on you all the time. The whole day's gone brilliantly. The weather's been fantastic. The only thing I've not been able to do is try out this new Daiwa waterproof stuff. Sake, Dan, I wasn't ready.